Hello, I'm Sam Hollis from Sam Hollis Web Design. Today I'm going to be talking to you about how to import email addresses and people into Moosend. So Moosend is a program we use, an app for sending email newsletters, automated emails, sending out blogs automatically, that sort of thing. I've got another video that gives you a tour, and we've got some more giving some more specific information. This one is going to be about how you can import people into your newsletter list. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is go to Moosend. So this is the dashboard which you see once you've logged in. So we want to go to mailing lists. The menu's on the left here, and you can see halfway down we've got mailing lists. Once you're there, it's just loading up. We should hopefully see we've got three mailing lists: blog, newsletter lists, and lead magnet. Now we might want to add a new newsletter list, so the first thing I'm going to do is show you how to do that. We simply go up to the top right here, create new list, click on there, give it a name, so that we're going to have, say, two different newsletters. So this is going to be newsletter list 2 for our second newsletter. Click save, and then it's added. There we go. We've got some options. We can click back on newsletter lists to get the lists. Okay, but the main thing I want to talk about here is how to add people to your newsletter lists. So there's a couple of different ways of doing this, and we want to go through it. So let's say we want to add some people to this new list we've made, newsletter list 2. So the first thing I'm going to do is click on it. Once you're here, we've got a few different options. The first thing I want to look at on the left here is custom fields. So when you're importing people, you want to think about what information you want to import. We've got the defaults here, which is email, name, and mobile. They have to stay, but you can add more if you want. So let's look at my list I want to import. Here are my people. I've got their email address, I've got their first name, and I've got their surname. Okay, now there's only name here, so if I want first name and surname separate, I need to separate them. I like to have them separate because if you do automatic emails, it's often nice just to have their first name that it automatically puts rather than both. So I'm going to add a custom field, and this is going to be a surname. Okay, data type is text. You could change that to something else if it's relevant. It doesn't need a default value, and it's not required, and it's not going to be hidden. Save the custom field. Job done. It's now in my list. Excellent. So let's go back to the dashboard here for my list. So let me just remind you how I've got here. Now I'm going to import people. So you click on mailing lists. You click on mailing lists you want to import people to. And then we've now got two ways of importing people. We can do them one at a time or lists. Both are useful. So one at a time is sometimes useful if you've got a big mailing list and you're just adding somebody new to it. Or you've got a customer list, you've got a new customer signed up, you're adding them to it. So I'll show you how to do that first, and then I'll show you how to do it in bulk if there's lots. So let's go to, if I want to add one, I need to go to members, and then I need to do create new. Create new button will still be there even if you do have some members. This list is empty because we just created it. There we go. So members email, so this is test@test.com. What's their name? I'll give them, they can be called Sam Test. There we go. Lastly, you have to give consent that you have permission to email them. This does not have to be full written consent. It has to comply with GDPR. And there's quite a lot of discussion about that. I'm not going to go through that now. But you can't just randomly add people to this. You need to have consent of one form or of another and tick to say you have, then create member. There we go, little notice saying the member's been subscribed and we can see them in the list. Okay. The other thing is we probably often want to add more than one. Sometimes you've got like an Excel spreadsheet or something like that. Lots of people want to import them all in one go. So how do we do that? So let me just remind you how we got here again. We click on mailing lists. Click on the mailing list we want to use. We then go to batch actions. We want to import members into a list. That's the top one. So we click select. And then there's a couple of ways of doing it. We can do it from a CSV or a text file, do it from an Excel file, or paste it. So I'm going to show you how to do it from file, and then I'm going to show you how to paste it. Both work perfectly well. So let's do Excel file to start with. It could be a CSV or text file. It just depends what format you've got it in. Okay, so this just means you've got an Excel sheet with them in. So there's my Excel sheet. That's already saved. I don't know where. So I just literally import your file, click on upload, and I just need to select the file. So let me just find that. There we go. Click on upload. Oops. Don't click on upload. Click on next. So, sorry. Start again. We've got the import demo. Click on yes. I've got them verified. That's again, you've got consent for everybody in there. Click on next. What we do now is we need to match the columns up. So we can see here it's spotted that these are email addresses. Obviously it's brought in the headings of my columns there. That's fine. It will ignore them in the import. So it's then got the list of the first name. So I then have to tick this arrow and say which field does this need to go in. So that is name. So I'll put name there. And then these are surnames. So I'll map these to surname. Okay, then if there's something on your, the other thing you can do, if there's a column that you don't actually want to import, you can go to ignore. So you can ignore a column if you want. I don't want to. I want name. So I've got them all assigned. Click next. And this just says, do you want an email when the import's done? Yes, please email me. Or you can choose a different email address. Import. And now it will import those for me. They will be on the list. So the other thing we're talking about is you can paste them in. If you've just got a small file, that's sometimes easier. So to do that, again, you go to mailing lists, choose your mailing list, click on back batch actions, click on import members into list, and this time paste text select. So literally, you can go to your document, highlight the text you want to go in, copy it, go to here, paste it. That simple. Yes, again, tick you've got consent. Click next. Oh, hang on. Click next too often. Okay. So, again, we've got to match the column. So this one's email. The next one is name. And the next one is surname, just like we did before. Match them up. Click next. Email me when it's done, or no thank you, or send someone else. Import them. Okay, done. Now, when I'm on my newsletter list, if I click on members, I can now see the people I've imported. That was the person I did in manually once, and these are the people I imported in bulk, and they are all there. So, that is how you import individual people or groups of people into mailing lists, or into your mailing list. So I hope that was helpful. I'm Sam Hollis from Sam Hollis Web Design.